This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Tin is a chemical element with the symbol. Overexposure to tin may cause problems with metabolizing essential trace elements such as copper and zinc, and some organotin compounds can be almost as toxic as cyanide contents. 1 characteristics 11 physical properties 12 chemical properties 13 isotopes 2 etymology 3 history 4 compounds and chemistry 41 inorganic compounds 42 hydrides 43 organotin compounds 5 occurrence 6 production 61 mining and smelting 62 industry 7 price and exchanges 71 price of tin in USD cents per kilogram 8 applications 81 solder 82 tin plating 83 specialized alloys 84 other applications 85 organotin compounds 851 PVC stabilizers 852 biocides 853 organic chemistry 854 Li-ion batteries 9 precautions 10 see also 11 notes 12 references 13 bibliography 14 external links characteristics Physical properties Droplet of solidified molten tin Tin is a soft, malleable, ductile and highly crystalline silvery white metal. When a bar of tin is bent, a crackling sound known as the tin cry can be heard from the twinning of the crystals. Tin melts at the low temperature of about 232. Well below zero. Isotopes Main article, isotopes of tin Tin has 10 stable isotopes, with atomic masses of 112, 114 through 120, 122 and 124, the greatest number of any element of these, the most abundant are 120 Sn almost a third of all tin, 118 Sn, and 116 Sn, while the least abundant is 115 Sn. The isotopes with even mass numbers have no nuclear spin, while those with odd have a spin of 1/2 tin. With its three common isotopes 116 Sn, 118 Sn and 120 Sn, is among the easiest elements to detect and analyze by NMR spectroscopy, and its chemical shifts are referenced against SnMe4. This large number of stable isotopes is thought to be a direct result of the atomic number 50, a magic number in nuclear physics. Tin also occurs in 29 unstable isotopes, encompassing all the remaining atomic masses from 99 to 137 apart from 126 Sn, with a half-life of 230,000 years. All the radioisotopes have a half-life of less than a year. The radioactive 100 Sn, discovered in 1994, and 132 Sn are one of the few nuclides with a doubly magic nucleus. Despite being unstable, having very lopsided proton-neutron ratios, they represent endpoints beyond which stability drops off rapidly. Another 30 metastable isomers have been characterized for isotopes between 111 and 131, the most stable being 121 MSN with a half-life of 439 years. The relative differences in the abundances of tin's stable isotopes can be explained by their different modes of formation in stellar nucleosynthesis. 116 Sn through 120 Sn inclusive are formed in the S process, slow neutron capture in most stars, and hence they are the most common isotopes, while 122 Sn and 124 Sn are only formed in the R process, rapid neutron capture in supernovae, and are less common. The isotopes 117 Sn through 120 Sn also receive contributions from the R process. Finally, the rarest proton-rich isotopes, 112 Sn, 114 Sn, and 115 Sn, cannot be made in significant amounts in the S or R processes and are considered among the P nuclei, whose origins are not well understood yet. Some speculated mechanisms for their formation include proton capture as well as photodisintegration, although 115 Sn may also be partially produced in the S process, both directly, and as the daughter of long-lived 115. In etymology, the word tin is shared among Germanic languages and can be traced back to reconstructed Proto-Germanic tinome. Cognates include German zinn, Swedish tin, and Dutch tin. It is not found in other branches of Indo-European, except by borrowing from Germanic, e.g. Irish tin from English. The Latin name stannum originally meant an alloy of silver and lead, and came to mean tin in the 4th century BCE. The earlier Latin word for it was plumbum candidum, or white lead. Stannum apparently came from an earlier stagnum meaning the same substance, the Origin of the Romance and Celtic terms for Tian. The origin of Stanum per Stone Agnum is unknown. It may be pre-Indo-European. The Myers Conversations Lexicon speculates on the contrary that Stanum is derived from the ancestor of Cornish Stean, and is proof that Cornwall in the 1st centuries AD was the main source of tin history. Main article, Tin Sources and Trade in Ancient Times. Ceremonial giant bronze dirk of the Plougrescant Amersham's type, Plougrescant, France, 1500-1300 BC. Tin extraction and use can be dated to the beginnings of the Bronze Age around 3000 BC, when it was observed that copper objects formed of polymetallic ores with different metal contents had different physical properties. The earliest bronze objects had a tin or arsenic content of less than 2% and are therefore believed to be the result of unintentional alloying due to trace metal content in the copper ore. The addition of a second metal to copper increases its hardness, lowers the melting temperature, and improves the casting process by producing a more fluid melt that cools to a denser, less spongy metal. This was an important innovation that allowed for the much more complex shapes cast in closed molds of the Bronze Age. Arsenical bronze objects appear first in the Near East, where arsenic is commonly found in association with copper ore, but the health risks were quickly realized and the quest for sources of the much less hazardous tin ores began early in the Bronze Age. This created the demand for rare tin metal and formed a trade network that linked the distant sources of tin to the markets of Bronze Age cultures. Cassiterite tin 4 oxide, the tin oxide form of tin, was most likely the original source of tin in ancient times. Other forms of tin ores are less abundant sulfides such as stannite that require a more involved smelting process. Cassiterite often accumulates in alluvial channels as placer deposits because it is harder, heavier, and more chemically resistant than the accompanying granite. Cassiterite is usually black, purple, or otherwise dark in color, and these deposits can be easily seen in river banks. Alluvial placer deposits could be easily collected and separated by methods similar to gold panning. Compounds and chemistry. See also, category, tin compounds. In the great majority of its compounds, tin has the oxidation state 2 or IV. Inorganic compounds. Halide compounds are known for both oxidation states for SNIV. All four halides are well known: tin 4-fluoride, tin 4-chloride, tin 4-bromide, and tin 4-iodide. The three heavier members are volatile molecular compounds, whereas the tetrafluoride is polymeric. All four halides are known for SNII also: tin 2-fluoride, tin 2-chloride, tin 2-bromide, and tin 2-iodide. All are polymeric solids. Of these eight compounds, only the iodides are colored tinny. Chloride, also known as stannous chloride, is the most important tin halide in a commercial sense, illustrating the roots to such compounds. Chlorine reacts with tin metal to give tin 4-chloride, whereas the reaction of hydrochloric acid and tin produces tin 2-chloride and hydrogen gas. Alternatively, tin 4-chloride and SN combine to stannous chloride by a process called comproportionation. Tin 4-chloride SN2 tin 2-chloride tin can form many oxides, sulfides, and other chalcogenide derivatives. The dioxide tin 4-oxide cassiterite forms when tin is heated in the presence of air. Tin 4-oxide is amphoteric, which means that it dissolves in both acidic and basic solutions. Stannates with the structure 2-, like K2, are also known, though the free stannic acid H2 is unknown. Sulfides of tin exist in both the 2 and 4 oxidation states, tinny sulfide and tinny sulfide. Mosaic gold ball and stick models of the structure of solid stannous chloride. Tin 2-chloride hydride stannane tin 4-hydride, with tin in the 4 oxidation state, is unstable. Organotin hydrides are, however, well known, e.g. tributyltin hydride SnC4H93H. These compounds release transient tributyl tin radicals, which are rare examples of compounds of tinny. Organotin compounds. Organotin compounds, sometimes called stannanes, are chemical compounds with tin-carbon bonds of the compounds of tin. The organic derivatives are the most useful commercially. Some organotin compounds are highly toxic and have been used as biocides. The first organotin compound to be reported was diethyltin diiodide C2H52 tin 2-iodide, reported by Edward Franklin in 1849. Most organotin compounds are colorless liquids or solids that are stable to air and water. They adopt tetrahedral geometry. Tetraalkyl and tetraaryltin compounds can be prepared using Grignard reagents. Tin 1-chloride 4-4-RmgBr(r)4SN(4MgBrCl). The mixed halide alkyls, which are more common and more important commercially than the tetraorgano derivatives, are prepared by redistribution reactions. Tin 1-chloride 4R. 4SN2 tin 2 chloride R2 divalent organotin compounds are uncommon, although more common than related divalent organogermanium and organosilicon compounds. The greater stabilization enjoyed by SNII is attributed to the inert pair effect. Organotiny compounds include both stanolines formula, R2SN, as seen for singlet carbons, and distanolines R4SN2, which are roughly equivalent to alkenes. Both classes exhibit unusual reactions occurrence. See also, category, tin mineral sample of cassiterite. The main ore of tin granular pieces of cassiterite, collected by placer mining tin, is generated via the long S process in low to medium mass stars with masses of 0.6 to 10 times that of Sun, and finally by beta decay of the heavy isotopes of indium. Tin is the 49th most abundant element in Earth's crust, representing 2.1% tin oxide content because of the higher specific gravity of tin dioxide. About 80% of mined tin is from secondary deposits found downstream from the primary lodes. Tin is often recovered from granules washed downstream in the past and deposited in valleys or the sea. The most economical ways of mining tin are by dredging, hydraulicking, or open pits. Most of the world's tin is produced from placer deposits, which may contain as little as 0.015% tin. World tin mine reserves tons, 2011 country reserves. 590,000. Run out within 20 years based on an extremely conservative extrapolation of 2% growth per year. Economically recoverable tin reserves year. Million tons 1965, 4,265, 1970, 3,930, 1975, 9,060, 1980, 9,100, 1985, 3,060, 1990, 7,100, 2000. 7,100, 2010, 5,200. Secondary, or scrap, tin is also an important source of the metal. Recovery of tin through secondary production, or recycling of scrap tin, is increasing rapidly, whereas the United States has neither mined since 1993 nor smelted tin since 1989. It was the largest secondary producer, recycling nearly 14,000 tons in 2006. New deposits are reported in southern Mongolia, and in 2009, new deposits of tin were discovered in Colombia by the Seminole Group. Colombia C. SAS production. Tin is produced by carbothermic reduction of the oxide ore with carbon or coke. Both reverberatory furnace and electric furnace can be used. Mining and smelting. Main article, tin mining industry. Candlestick made of tin. The 10 largest companies produced most of the world's tin in 2007. It is not clear which of these companies include tin smelted from the mine at Bissi, Democratic Republic of the Congo, which is controlled by a renegade militia and produces 15,000 tons. Most of the world's tin is traded on the London Metal Exchange LME, from 8 countries, under 17 brands. Largest tin producing companies. Tons company. Polity 2006-2007% change. Yunnan Tin China 52,339, 61,129, 167 pt. Timah Indonesia 44,689, 58,325, 305. Minchur Peru 40,977, 35,940 minus 123. Malay China 52,339, 61,129, 167. Malaysia Smelting Corp. Malaysia 22,850, 25,471, 115. Thaisarco Thailand 27,828. 19,826 minus 288. Yunnan Chengfeng China 21,765, 18,000 minus 178. Luzhou China Tin China 13,499, 13,193 minus 23. M. Vinto Bolivia 11,804, 9,448 minus 200. Gold Bell Group China 4,696, 8,709 price and exchanges. World production and price. U.S. exchange of tin. Tin is unique among other mineral commodities by the complex agreements between producer countries and consumer countries dating back to 1921. The earlier agreements tended to be somewhat informal and sporadic and led to the first International Tin Agreement in 1956, the first of a continuously numbered series that effectively collapsed in 1985. Through this series of agreements, agreements, the International Tin Council ITC had a considerable effect on tin prices. The ITC supported the price of tin during periods of low prices by buying tin for its buffer stockpile and was able to restrain the price during periods of high prices by selling tin from the stockpile. This was an anti-free market approach, designed to assure a sufficient flow of tin to consumer countries and a profit for producer countries. However, the buffer stockpile was not sufficiently large, and during most of those 29 years tin prices rose, sometimes sharply, especially from 1973 through 1980 when rampant inflation plagued many world economies. During the late 1970s and early 1980s, the U.S. government tin stockpile was in an aggressive selling mode, partly to take advantage of the historically high tin prices. The sharp recession of 1981-82 proved to be quite harsh on the tin industry. Tin consumption declined dramatically. The ITC was able to avoid truly steep declines through accelerated buying for its buffer stockpile. This activity required the ITC to borrow extensively from banks and metal trading firms to augment its resources. The ITC continued to borrow until late 1985, when it reached its credit limit immediately. A major tin crisis followed. Tin was delisted from trading on the London Metal Exchange for about 3 years. The ITC dissolved soon afterward, and the price of tin, now in a free market environment, plummeted sharply to $4 per pound and remained at that level through the 1990s. The price increased again by 2010 with a rebound in consumption following the 2008-09 world economic crisis, accompanying restocking and continued growth in consumption by the world's developing economies. London Metal Exchange LME is the principal trading site for tin. Other tin contract markets are Kuala Lumpur Tin Market KLTM and Indonesia Tin Exchange INATIN. Price of tin in USD cents per kilogram. Tin USD cents per kilogram 2008, 2009, 2010. 2011 2012 price 1851 1357 2041 2605 2113 source Helgi Library. Applications: world consumption of refined tin by end use 2006. In 2006, about half of all tin produced was used in solder. The rest was divided between tin plating, tin chemicals, brass and bronze alloys, and niche uses. Solder: a coil of lead free solder wire. Tin has long been used in alloys with lead as solder, in amounts 5-70% with W. Tin forms a eutectic mixture with lead in the proportion 63% tin and 37% lead. Such solders are primarily used for joining pipes or electric circuits, since the European Union Waste Electrical and Electronic Equipment Directive WEEE Directive and Restriction of Hazardous Substances Directive came into effect on 1 July 2006. The lead content in such alloys has decreased. Replacing lead has many problems, including a higher melting point, and the formation of tin whiskers causing electrical problems. Tin pest can occur in lead-free solders, leading to loss of the soldered joint. Replacement alloys are rapidly being found, although problems of joint integrity remain. Tin plating. Tin bonds readily to iron and is used for coating lead, zinc and steel to prevent corrosion. Tin plated steel containers are widely used for food preservation, and this forms a large part of the market for metallic tin. A tinplate canister for preserving food was first manufactured in London in 1812. Speakers of British English call them tins, while speakers of American English call them cans or tin cans. One derivation of such use is the slang term tinny or tinny, meaning can of beer. The tin whistle is so called because it was first mass-produced in tin-plated steel. Specialized alloys: pewter plate. Tin in combination with other elements forms a wide variety of useful alloys. Tin is most commonly alloyed with copper. Pewter is 85-99% tin. Bearing metal has a high percentage of tin as well. Bronze is mostly copper, 12% tin, while addition of phosphorus gives phosphor bronze. Bell metal is also a copper tin alloy, containing 22% tin. Tin has sometimes been used in coinage. For example, it once formed a single-digit percentage, usually 5% or less, of American and Canadian pennies, because copper is often the major metal in such coins, sometimes including zinc. These could be called bronze and or brass alloys. Tin-plated metal from a can. Artisan Alfonso Santiago Leyva and his son working tin sheets. The niobium tin compound NB3SN is commercially used in coils of superconducting magnets for its high critical temperature 18. Advantages of using tin for pipes include its appearance, its workability, and resistance to corrosion. Other applications: a 21st century reproduction barn lantern made of punched tin-plated steel, also called pierced tin, is an artisan technique originating in Central Europe for creating housewares that are both functional and decorative. Decorative piercing designs exist in a wide variety, based on local tradition and the artisan's personal creations. Punched tin lanterns are the most common application of this artisan technique. The light of a candle shining through the pierced design creates a decorative light pattern in the room where it sits. Lanterns and other punched tin articles were created in the New World from the earliest European settlement. A well-known example is the Revere lantern, named after Paul Revere before the modern era. In some areas of the Alps, a goat or sheep's horn would be sharpened and a tin panel would be punched out using the alphabet and numbers from 1 to 9. This learning tool was known appropriately as the horn. Modern reproductions are decorated with such motifs as hearts and tulips in America. Pie safes and food safes were in use in the days before refrigeration. These were wooden cupboards of various styles and sizes, either floor-standing or hanging cupboards. Meant to discourage vermin and insects and to keep dust from perishable foodstuffs, these cabinets had tinplate inserts in the doors and sometimes in the sides, punched out by the homeowner, cabinetmaker, or a tinsmith in varying designs to allow for air circulation while excluding flies. Modern reproductions of these articles remain popular in North America. Window glass is most often made by floating molten glass on molten tin float glass, resulting in a flat and flawless surface. This is also called the Pilkington process. Tin is also used as a negative electrode in advanced Li-ion batteries. Its application is somewhat limited by the fact that some tin surfaces catalyze decomposition of carbonate-based electrolytes used in Li-ion batteries. Tinny fluoride is added to some dental care products as stannous fluoride, tin 2 fluoride. Tinny fluoride can be mixed with calcium abrasives, while the more common sodium fluoride gradually becomes biologically inactive in the presence of calcium compounds. It has also been shown to be more effective than sodium fluoride in controlling gingivitis. Organotin compounds. Main article: organotin. Chemistry of all the chemical compounds of tin. The organotin compounds are most heavily used worldwide. Industrial production probably exceeds 50,000 tons PVC stabilizers. The major commercial application of organotin compounds is in the stabilization of PVC plastics. In the absence of such stabilizers, PVC would otherwise rapidly degrade under heat, light, and atmospheric oxygen, resulting in discolored, brittle products. Tin scavenges labile chloride ions Cl-, which would otherwise initiate loss of HCl from the plastic material. Typical tin compounds are carboxylic acid derivatives of dibutyltin dichloride, such as the dilaurate biocides. Some organotin compounds are relatively toxic, with both advantages and problems. They are used for biocidal properties as fungicides, pesticides, algicides, wood preservatives, and antifouling agents. Tributyltin oxide is used as a wood preservative. Tributyltin was used as additive for ship paint to prevent growth of marine organisms on ships, with use declining after organotin compounds were recognized as persistent organic pollutants with an extremely high toxicity for some marine organisms. The dog whelk, for example. The EU banned the use of organotin compounds in 2003, while concerns over the toxicity of these compounds to marine life and damage to the reproduction and growth of some marine species. Some reports describe biological effects to marine life at a concentration of 1 nanogram per liter have led to a worldwide ban by the International Maritime Organization. Many nations now restrict the use of organotin compounds to vessels greater than 25. Long. Organic chemistry. Some tin reagents are useful in organic chemistry in the largest application. Stannous chloride is a common reducing agent for the conversion of nitro and oxime groups to amines. The Stille reaction couples organotin compounds with organic halides or pseudohalides. Li-ion batteries. Tin forms several intermetallic phases with lithium metal, making it a potentially attractive material for battery applications. Large volumetric expansion of tin upon alloying with lithium and instability of the tin organic electrolyte interface at low electrochemical potentials are the greatest challenges to employment in commercial cells. The problem was partially solved by Sony. Tin intermetallic compound with cobalt and carbon has been implemented by Sony in its Nexalion cells released in late 2000s. The composition of the active material is approximately SNO3CO4CO3. Recent research showed that only some crystalline facets of tetragonal beta SN are responsible for undesirable electrochemical activity. Radioactivity Precautions Main Article, tin poisoning. Cases of poisoning from tin metal, its oxides, and its salts are almost unknown. On the other hand, certain organotin compounds are almost as toxic as cyanide. Exposure to tin in the workplace may occur by inhalation, skin contact, and eye contact. The Occupational Safety and Health Administration OSHA has set the legal limit permissible exposure limit for tin exposure in the workplace as 2.5 elements carbon group chemical elements sorted. Carat Lide, Dr., ed. 2005, Magnetic Susceptibility of the Elements and Inorganic Compounds, CRC Handbook of Chemistry and Physics PDF 86th ed. Boca Raton FL, CRC Press ISBN. Buttons on the soldiers' uniforms disintegrated over time, contributing to the defeat of the Grande Armée. Le Carrère, Penny, Burrison, J. 2004. Napoleon's Buttons, 17 Molecules That Changed History. New York, Penguin Group USA. 4 June 2011. Retrieved 5 May 2009. Carat Czerny, J., Weisgerber, G. 2003. The Bronze Age Tin Mines in Central Asia. In Jimlia Mare, A., Lo Schiavo, F. The Problem of Early Tin. Oxford, Archaeopress pp. Carat J. M. Leger, J. Haynes, A. Touffe 1996. The High Pressure Behavior of the Cotunnite and Post-Cotunnite Phases of Lead-2-Chloride and Tin-2-Chloride, J. Phys. Chem. Solids 57-1-7-16. Bibcode, 1996 JPCS 577 L. doi, 101,016-0022-3697950060-7. Carat Shu, Frank H. 1982. The Physical Universe, An Introduction to Astronomy, 119-121 ISBN. Formations and Rare Metal. Metallogeny of Mongolia. Economic Geology 93-520 doi, 102,113, Jisikangio 903,520. Carat, http://helgolibrary.com/indicators/index/tin-usd-cents-per-kg, 10 February 2014. Carat, Tin Use Survey 2007, ETRI archived from the original on 7 December 2008. Retrieved 21 November 2008. Carat Williams, Robert S. 2007. Principles of Metallography. Read Books pp.